Limited, who is in our Sydney CBD studio tonight. And Tom, what unique properties are hitting the papers this weekend you can tell us about?
Okay, much cheaper than the one you've been talking about there, Liz.
Hope so.
We've got one, it's a penthouse that's actually made up of two penthouses. In 2009 and 2010, the owners got two penthouses, put them together. It's on the Gold Coast in Broadbeach. This is quite a spectacular property, in fact, itself. But I mean, not many properties I know in Australia have got their own gymnasium, their own massage room. This is part of the actual unit, swimming pool. It is presented to you by Ray White at Broadbeach. I was talking to Larry Milan. Quite a unique property. It is in the $10 million price bracket, and they're expecting offers over that. And every room has got views of either the ocean or the hinterland, skyline views right throughout as well. So it's definitely worth considering. And the Gold Coast has been in the doldrums for quite some time, but over the last 6 months, Liz, we've seen improvement in that marketplace. And we're hoping that someone's got $10 million that doesn't want to go overseas and can buy this property.
Okay, and you're also looking at a property in Warunga, New South Wales, Tom.
Correct. We picked this one, Liz, because of its proximity to great schools, good transport, the village. I was talking to LJ Hooker there, Rob Ward, and he told me that the reduction in value of the Australian dollar that we've seen of 15 to 18% in recent times has attracted a lot of overseas buyers again to Australia real estate in that upper end. Definitely a strong attraction from Asian buyers, and this property is on the market at $3.49 million. It was advertised in the North Shore Times, and it's on at a half an acre a block, which is it's huge for Warunga.
Definitely. All right, and also you've been looking into some research, the latest Pulse research in real estate. What can you tell us?
Yes, so News Limited's Pulse research showed two interesting things that I think want to talk about. The first thing is that 60% of buyers are looking within 10 kilometres, even in 2013. They're not moving too far afield, so you're not seeing people in Sydney wanting to move to America or even to Brisbane for that fact. And the second bit of data is Australia is real estate mad, not only on television shows, but also in newspapers. 80% of people that are reading or flipping through a newspaper are reading the real estate section even when they're not looking to buy a property. People have just got this passive experience of wanting to read about real estate when they're actually not looking to buy real estate. So that's what came out of Pulse.
Very interesting, maybe dreaming about that property they've always wanted but maybe can't afford.
Correct.
Tom Panos from News Limited, always a pleasure. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Liz. See you later, guys.
See you, Tom.
Time for a quick break here on Your Property Empire. Stay with us, though. When we get back, we'll be checking out a viewer's dilemma and offering our thoughts on which way